Good morning to all of you. My old friend, Professor Manoj Gaur, who is the director of IIT Jammu. He was professor from MNIT, Jaipur, and he became director. This has happened first time in the history of India. My congratulations to Professor Manoj Singh. And he deserved this, and he will prove that Government of India has taken a right decision at right time and has opened door for all of us. Professor S.K. Garg, Pro Vice Chancellor of DTU, Professor Indu, Head of Electronics, different deans of Delhi Technological University, respected teachers, my dear students, friends, congratulations for attending this workshop. Why I am saying congratulations for attending this workshop? This topic is very important, very relevant for all of us. Our earlier generations could not face this type of challenge. This time is very, very different, transparent, and we have to become very, very responsible, otherwise we will come in trouble, or someone else can create a trap for us and then we will come in trouble. A senior professor shared me his experience about plagiarism or the copyright violation. And those were the early days, I should say, what should I say, Industrial Revolution 2. Right now they have also differentiated amongst the industrial revolutions. Steam engine triggered Industrial Revolution 1, then electricity triggered Industrial Revolution 2, and internet triggered 3rd. Whatever it is, but earlier, like before internet, a senior professor received a PhD thesis from a university. He received a PhD thesis from a university, and when he opened the envelope, he was shocked to see his own thesis. He was shocked to see his own thesis submitted 20 years back in a different university. Title same, everything same, 100% plagiarized. And he said, I did not know what to do now. Same thesis. Then he wrote to the vice chancellor of that university. He said, someone has copied, someone has this, but this is exactly same. Please do something. Then after 1 year, what happened? Same student came to the professor and he said, sir, I have completed my PhD. I want your blessings for the same. He said, you have completed? It means you have changed everything? You have changed everything? No, sir, but please don't create fuss now because I have managed everything now. New vice chancellor has joined and he has given permission for the same. I want your blessing so that please do not create anything out of it because it is related to my career. I have got a job, then everything will come in trouble. Then professor thought, okay, he just, he did not do anything. Jane do, chalta hai. But it happened. It means what? In those days, there was no transparency. A thesis submitted to a IIT, one can easily submit to in NIT or from a foreign university thesis, but right now those days are over. Everything is connected, and now Government of India has taken a decision. Every thesis should be on Shodh Ganga, which is mandated to all universities as per directive issued by University Grants Commission. It means what? Whenever, wherever we submit, it doesn't make any difference. It should not be copied from anywhere. This is one thing. Second incident, when I was professor teaching in Indraprastha University, Delhi, I was also writing a book. And my habit is, if I have developed a chapter second, I will teach that in the class, and after that I distribute the notes to the students. Although I was in the process of writing the book, it was somewhere in 2003, I had written 4 or 5 chapters. I gave all those 4 or 5 chapters to my dear students, or postgraduate students. And one fine day, one student gave me a book on software testing, having all my six chapters, all my six chapters, and 7th, 8th, 9th, and 1st, which I had not written those chapters till date, but you know, I was using material from other books. So, like they were having material of all 8, 9 chapters, and my dear student published the book. I called him, I said, you have copied this material, you should not have done it. But sir, no, I have done it in the interest of students because notes were very good. I thought, let me publish. That's why I have done it. Is this the way of doing it? Kehta sir, what is wrong in this? I have written, I have edited everything. I have edited everything and sir, I have changed 10 pages completely. I have changed 10 pages completely. Then, you know, I was also, then I called the publisher also. I wanted to discuss. But after that, as a teacher, I thought, jaane do na. Then I did not do anything. Book is still in the market. Book still doing very well. And then after that, the student has written 5-10 more books, maybe in the same way. Maybe in the same way. But you know what I thought there as a teacher, mereko bada man rakhna chahiye. I know how to write, I will write. Only my project will be delayed. It was delayed and then book came after in 2010. Besides that. But those days are over now. It is not possible whether you are a student or a teacher or something. Recently, you know, I was Vice Chancellor of MS University, Vadodara, where we were conducting CAS interviews. It was a faculty of law, an associate professor appeared for the post of professor. He was having 11 publications in September, volume 1 issue, 11 papers. October, 12 papers in the same issue, two pages papers, 12. And then in the next issue, 6 papers. Total about 26 papers in volume 1, 2, 3 of a new journal. New journal published from Ahmedabad. Then I asked him, in the last 10-15 years you have not written anything and now, you know, in the last 3-4 months you have published so many papers. He said, yes sir, because you have issued notification for CAS interviews and the guidelines of UGC. I had no option but to do it because I should have 400 API. So I wrote this. I said, have you written this 2 pages papers, 10, 12? He said, no sir, I have taken from internet. Everything is correct. Everything is correct. I have directly taken from internet. Poor fellow was not knowing the implications of the things. He thought, if I take something from the internet, reorganize that thing, it is all right. Is it not unethical? I am not saying illegal, but is it not unethical to publish like this? He said, sir, I don't know. You are an associate professor of law and you say, I don't know. He said, sir, I really don't know. But my objective was to have 400 API. I did it. And this journal is a new journal, which I requested my friend to start. He has started that journal and these publications, what is wrong in that? He argued, but you know, jo hona tha, humne usko select nahi kiya. Nahi kiya to uska cost bhi aaya. Baad mein wo sara ek alag issue hai. He attacked and everything happened. Now, suspend hai, jail mein hai, bahut sara raha issue uska. Wo ek alag dimension hai. The point is, sometimes, you know, if you have some different type of, you know, attributes and you do not know the law, then problem is very, very serious. Anything can happen. Anything can happen to anyone, so we should be very, very clear now that those days are over. My dear students who are new to, in this field, this workshop will help you to understand the complexities, to understand the difficulties of the subject. Reason is what, you know, in our country, most of us are not coming from English background. It means what? Whenever we have to write in a language which is foreign to us, we do understand the difficulties. Had it been your mother language, situation would have been different, which I feel. But this is also a reality that we have to write in English. Now we have no option. It is better. Sooner we recognize this and start working in this area, that will help you in non-verbals. So try to develop your own expression. I am not saying the Turnitin will help you or Viper will help you or some softwares will help you. Yes, they will check you. That is the only the postmortem activity. But you know, promise to yourself that we will not copy anything from anywhere. We will develop, we will make effort to develop our own expression, whether it is poor expression or a good expression. Because if today my expression is poor, I take special effort, then tomorrow it will be improved. This we should be very, very clear. So I would like to have promised from all of you that we will not copy anything from anywhere. Publishing paper is, yes, it is important. Sometimes it is mandatory also. But those compelling pressures will not change this promise of copying anything from anywhere. We will not do it. We will develop our own expression, and there are ways and means to develop own expressions. Write one page daily, read a book of your interest. Regularly read books of your interest. You will see that within six months or a year, things will improve for you. And you know, there is always a debate on quality and quantity of papers. Right now, because our total effort is to publish papers, if we are PhD students or teachers, because there is a weightage, there is an importance associated with that. But you know, quality is important, quantity is not that important. Don't, like when it comes to attending conferences also, attend few conferences. Whenever we see the bioretas now, what is happening? 20 conferences and 15-20 papers. But when it comes to publications in good journals, hardly a few, one or two. It is better to have 3-4 papers in good journals rather than having in many conferences. Conference, I am not against conferences. Conference is good. Please publish there also. There are many, many good conferences. But here, what is requirement? Requirement is to change our mindset that we will not copy anything. हमसे नहीं लिखा जा रहा तो कोई बात नहीं लिखेंगे सीखेंगे. Attend courses. Now good number of MOOCs courses are available to improve your technical writing, language, expression. Take advantage of that. If there are challenges, there are solutions also. And this workshop will, you know, what should I say, motivate some of you to work in that direction, then the purpose of the workshop will be fulfilled. I am thankful to Professor Indu and Professor Rajeshwari and others, and particularly Professor Garg, for organizing this workshop, which will help all of us to be a better writer, to be a better researcher, and to be a better academician. All the best to all of you. Thank you very much.